Man, I'll tell you, this record, I could talk for a long time about this record because it was one of those periods in your life where you've come off some big changes, traumatic changes, because the band broke up to a certain degree. Kenny and I carried on. We didn't know whether we were going to survive, and we got a tremendous amount of support from a number of key people that kept us going. And you know, we had this incredible period of growth with Red Rider, and a bunch of years touring with all kinds of people. And then all of a sudden we had, you know, when you have good times, you're bound to come out and you're gonna bottom out a bit. That's the nature of life, the dynamic of life, and that, the ebb and flow of it. So I came out of it, had a young daughter, and that changed a lot of things in my life. And I started reflecting, you know, on the stuff I had gone through, you know. And Kenny and I set up shop in a studio on Bering Avenue, you know, and I was living out in the East End of Toronto with Kathy and Cody, my young daughter. And this song came out of it, and it was interesting because the song is one of the first songs I used a loop. And it was a very primitive loop, and a loop is kind of a modal thing, a musical thing that you end up looping, so it plays over and over again. And I built the song on top of it, and it reflects on the different stages of life you go through as a man. You know, you start out and you think that, man, if I don't get something done, then nobody's gonna, you know, my life won't have mattered, you know. And then you go through a stage where you get desperate and you get ambitious and you're not really appreciating some of the things you go through. And then of course you fall in love. And then you have a family. And then you go through the changes that we went through with the band, where things bottomed out a little bit after the Breaking Curfew record. And then we carried on. And we didn't, you know, at that point I didn't know what I was gonna do, but we did carry on. And this record was just, it's funny, it's like the phoenix rising from the dust, you know, and that's the way I look at it. And we went to Wales. We had an incredible experience in Wales recording this at Rockfield. And Robert Plant would come and hang out, have breakfast with us, because he was living there at the time. And it was one of those old English Welsh towns that they didn't allow big buildings, cobblestone streets and all of that. And so the whole record just had a magic about it. And probably this record and the Madman World record were the two records, and of course the first record, you know, Don't Fight It with White Hot. Those three records just were magical times. Neruda, in its own way, was magical as well. But to me, it's just one of those songs, probably more of a signature song than anything I've done, with the possible exception, especially in Canada, of Big League, you know, which to me is the hockey song. I'm very proud of that song, very cultural song. But this song, it just resonates with so many people, you know, and it's really about that magic of life and how you go through the different changes of life, and it's always evolving. You know, when I turned 17, when I turned 21, when I turned 25, when I turned 31, you know, so I guess I got to write another couple of verses for this song, you know, but it's... We do go through those changes, and we grow through those changes. And to me, the music's always been my way of documenting it. And this song, I think, resonates with people from that point of view, those different changes you go through and as you grow in life. Because we're here to learn, we're here to grow, and I'm a big believer in that. And this song reflects on that, you know? But it was magical. Graham Broad played drums on this. He now plays with Roger Waters, incredible English drummer. And Spider, of course, played bass on this. One of my favorite bass players on the planet. But it's one of those songs, you know, we can't not play live. You know, it's just one of those songs that just, we got to keep playing. And I guess I'll be playing it for the rest of my life, with another couple of chapters written in. And maybe I'll just express those chapters in the way I approach life, you know. Boy Inside the Man. Yeah, magical. for me.